me some melodious sonnet, sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount I'm fixed upon it, mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise my shall see thy lovely face, clothed then in blood-washed linen. How I'll sing thy sovereign grace. Come, my Lord, no longer tarry, take my ransomed soul away. Send thy angels now to carry
Well, good morning and welcome to our Sunday morning prayer. We are at my home, at my home office today. Our niece is staying with us, and we found out first thing this morning that she has tested positive for COVID. She's here with UW for some nursing, with a nursing program just for the weekend. So a little Sunday morning gift for us. But we're going to try this from home. We'll do the morning prayer straight from the morning prayer book. Again, I'm glad you're able to join us this morning. I got Julie to come and help out this morning since we're going to be at home. It's awfully cold outside, so it looks like a good day to stay inside anyway. St. Matthew's Episcopal Cathedral is who we are this morning, and welcome. Our service is going to begin today.
Announcements?
Announcements. Yeah, Julie has an announcement while we're here.
Good morning. Those of you who joined us last week know that I talked about my period project in relation to Love Laramie. Love Laramie helps students with hygiene items, and they're running a big collection for the month of November, so I would like everyone to donate to that. Feminine hygiene products. You can donate through the church office. If you go to the 4th Street entrance of Hunter Hall, there's a basket that you can put items into, or you can mail a check into the office. I've actually seen some of you around town, and you've given me money, which has been wonderful. I would also like to add that I got a call from Family Promise, and they are in need as well. So there's a lot of need out there for feminine hygiene products right now. So we'll be able to help school-age kids and those women and girls who are homeless in our community. So please give. You're going to be hearing this from me all November, so try not to get tired of it. But please, if we can give, this is a need within our community right now. Thank you.
Thanks, Julie. Also, I did want to give special thanks for today's flowers. Unfortunately, I don't have them with me. They're at the cathedral, but I'm sure that Marilyn will have them on Facebook later. I would imagine that they are gorgeous because Killian's always does gorgeous flowers. Today, they're given to the glory of God and in loving memory of Joseph Moore, a familial patriarch, and they're given by Estella Spurzel and her family. Something a little bit different today. If we could start out, let's just sing together a cappella. Can we sing together the first verse of Amazing Grace, just the first one? Because I don't have my hymnal with me. So let's start our service with singing that. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. I didn't tell Julie we were doing that this morning. If you would turn with me to page number 78 of the Book of Common Prayer, if you have that with you. Page number 78 for morning prayer. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Send out your light and your truth, that they may lead me and bring me to your holy hill and to your holy dwelling. On page 79, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Continuing on page 80. Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. On page 82, let us say together the Jubilate. Page 82. Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people and a sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And his faithfulness endures from age to age. Julie, would you read the psalm for us today?
The psalm today is Psalm 70, found on page 682. Psalm 70. Be pleased, O God, to deliver me. O Lord, make haste to help me. Let those who seek my life be ashamed and altogether dismayed. Let those who take pleasure in my misfortune draw back and be disgraced. Let those who say to me, aha, and gloat over me turn back because they are ashamed. Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. Let those who love your salvation say forever, great is the Lord. But as for me, I am poor and needy. Come to me speedily, O God. You are my helper and my deliverer. O Lord, do not tarry.
Thank you. And our first lesson today.
First lesson is from the Wisdom of Solomon. Wisdom is radiant and unfading, and she is easily discerned by those who love her, and is found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known to those who desire her. One who rises early to seek her will have no difficulty, for she will be found sitting at the gate. To fix one's thought on her is perfect understanding, and one who is vigilant on her account will soon be free from care, because she goes about seeking those worthy of her, and she graciously appears to them in their paths and meets them in every thought. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The first canticle we're going to do today is canticle number 9. It's on page 86 of the Book of Common Prayer. It's the first song of Isaiah, which is taken from Isaiah 12, 2 through 6. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense, and he will be my savior. Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day you shall say, give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the peoples. See that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion, ring out your joy, for the great one in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
And our second lesson today?
The second lesson is from Thessalonians. We do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our second canticle is Canticle 10. It's the second song of Isaiah, which is taken from Isaiah 55, 6 through 11. It's on page 86 of the Book of Common Prayer. Seek the Lord while he wills to be found. Call upon him when he draws near. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the evil ones their thoughts, and let them turn to the Lord, and he will have compassion. And to our God, for he will richly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and snow fall from the heavens and return not again, but water the earth, bringing forth life and giving growth, seed for sowing and bread for eating, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish that which I have proposed and prosper in that for which I sent it. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our gospel reading this morning is taken from Matthew. It's Matthew chapter 25, verses 1 through 13. Matthew 25, 1 through 13. Then the kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them. But the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight there was a shout, "Look, here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him." Then all of those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise replied, "No, there will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourselves." And while they went to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went with him into the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the other bridesmaids came also, saying, "Lord, open up to us." But he replied, "Truly I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. Do you remember the words, "Ready or not, here I come"? These are the words spoken often as a child, when I was a child growing up in the old neighborhood, a neighborhood that had, anywhere between 12 and 20 kids that would come out on an evening to play hide and seek. We spanned the entire neighborhood. We would draw boundaries so as far as we could go to play hide and seek. As the counter would begin, everybody would scramble to find places behind cars, behind houses, shrubs, trees, wherever they could go, and they held their silence and they sat there and they waited until they heard, "Ready or not, here I come." And we all just sat there, hoping that we would not be found, hoping we would not be given up by any who were next to us, hoping we'd make it through to be the last person found. Ready or not, here I come. Our gospel reading today, Jesus is addressing the people who have asked, when will the end be? When will the end times be? When is this going to come to a head? When are we all going to ascend into heaven? When will that glorious time be? So Jesus begins again to tell us this parable of the bridesmaids, those that were prepared to wait, and those that weren't prepared. Those that were prepared got to go in and celebrate with the bridegroom. This is a common theme that was used in parables. It was easily understood because the bridegroom or the bridesmaids would all sit and wait for the bridegroom to show up that evening for a week-long party. And when the bridegroom would show up, they would usher him into the room and the party would begin. Apparently the doors were shut thereafter, and only those that were prepared got to go in, according to this parable. Now it is stretched a bit because Jesus has the other bridesmaids telling the unwise ones to go to the dealer and find some oil to use. And of course, there weren't any dealers open. But it just goes to tell us, just like he did in the end, like Jesus said, we need to be ready. Be ready for that time that is going to be the time when we see Jesus. Now, of course, we know we are thinking about the end times, the times of when the world comes to an end, when we all ascend into heaven, when that glorious time comes of the second coming of Jesus. That's what they were all thinking about. But I think today we could also think about that time that is our own end time, that time when we don't know actually when that time is going to come, and we need to be ready. I guess, as they'll say, ready to meet my Maker. But we need to be ready. But unlike the story that I told of hide and seek, while we're waiting, we should not just sit there quietly, hoping not to be found. Sit there quietly out of the way so that nobody would notice us. Sit there quietly so that the master of the game wouldn't even know we were there. In fact, Jesus tells us while we're waiting, we do have things to do. We have the commandments to pass on. We have the greatest commandment, of course, to go and make disciples of all nations. We have to ensure that there's justice. We need to ensure that there's peace. We need to ensure that there's love between each other. We need to stand up and we need to do things and not sit quietly by, but make sure that we are indeed heard. And I think if we're heard by others, I think the Lord will hear us as well. My friends, we're not called to just sit by quietly. We saw that over the past week or so, a very long week that we had, as people in huge numbers stood up to vote. Well, I think we should carry that on. That should go forward. That idea of that we need to make change. We need to make changes around us. We need to make changes within us. And we need to make changes nationally and globally. And instead of sitting by quietly, waiting, hoping not to be noticed, I think we need to spread the good news. Spread the good news that we are loved, and that in loving, others will know that love, and that love will spread like a pandemic. I talk about this all of the time, of course, and I'm sure you're getting tired of it, but really that's what Jesus came down to tell us is we need to care for other people and to love God. That was the primary message, so that keeps eking into the sermons. In Thessalonians, Paul tells us the good news that those that have known God in the past and those that know Jesus now will ascend into heaven, will find their way to the kingdom of heaven. And it's good news for those of us that are here waiting. But as he tells us in his letter, we need to encourage one another with these words. We need to spend this time, hopefully not waiting to die, but to spend this time living, telling others about living and about the good news, and to stand up, be part of life, and pass it on. This pandemic, when we feel like we're just perpetually waiting, Julie and I are going to spend the next several days waiting, but there's so much we can do while we wait, so many things that we can accomplish, so many plans that can be made, so many ways that we can reach out to others and show our love for them, so many ways that we can demonstrate God's love all the way around us. Julie's period project that she's going to keep doing from home while we're doing this. My friends, let us not just sit and wait quietly. Let us discover ways in which, in hope and in glory and in love, we can live. And we can do so much more. All this I pray in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. And now, if you would turn with me, if you have your books of common prayer, I'd like to go to page 96 and let us say together the Apostles' Creed. Page 96. Let us say together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together, saying those words that Jesus taught us so long ago to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom,
and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And on the bottom of page 97, let's do suffrage A, our versicle and response. Bottom of 97. Show us your mercy, O Lord.
And grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Our collect for the day is found on page 236. Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son came into the world that he might destroy the works of the devil and make us children of God and heirs of eternal life, grant that having this hope, we may purify ourselves as he is pure, that when he comes again with power and great glory, we may be made like him in his eternal and glorious kingdom, where he lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Today, I have a few different collects that I wanted to share. The first is collect number 3, and it's found on page 815. This is the collect number 3 for the human family. All of these collects today seemed appropriate for the time that we're in right now. Let us pray. O God, you made us in your own image and redeemed us through Jesus, your Son. Look with compassion on the whole human family. Take away the arrogance and hatred which infect our hearts. Break down the walls that separate us. Unite us in bonds of love and work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purposes on earth, that in your good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony around your heavenly throne, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now, if you have your books and want to turn to page 823, this is a prayer for social justice. It's prayer number 27 on 823. Grant, O God, that your holy, life-giving Spirit may so move every human heart, and especially the hearts of the people of this land, that barriers which divide us may crumble, suspicions disappear, and hatred cease, that our divisions being healed, we may live in justice and peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And page 815 again. This is a prayer for peace. Let us pray. Eternal God, in whose perfect kingdom no sword is drawn but the sword of righteousness, no strength known but the strength of love, so mightily spread abroad your Spirit that all peoples may be gathered under the banner of the Prince of Peace, as children of one Father, to whom be dominion and glory now and forever. Amen. Amen. And our final canticle is on page 823, as Wednesday is Veterans Day, canticle number 25. Almighty God, we commend to your gracious care and keeping all the men and women of our armed forces at home and abroad. Defend them day by day with your heavenly grace. Strengthen them in their trials and temptations. Give them courage to face the perils which beset them. And grant them a sense of your abiding presence wherever they may be. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And now, if you would turn with me to page 100, down near the bottom, let us say a prayer for mission. Let's say this one together. Bottom of page 100, second one up. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all the members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. And on page 102, a prayer of St. Chrysostom. Let's say this one together, please. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions, as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And now may the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. And may all the blessings of heaven be upon you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May your Sunday be blessed. May your week be blessed. May you see the presence of Christ all the way around you and through you. And may you pass that peace through all that you see. Amen. Thank you for joining us today. And we'll be talking to you. Have a good Sunday. Bye now.